You know, I thought Shawshank Redemption was a great movie. I thought they did an excellent job of showing how an inmate can become institutionalized. There was something flawed in the rape episodes, and it was subtle, but it was very important. The narrator referred to the guys that were doing the rapes as the sisters, right? That's where the mistake was, because the sisters would imply they're gay. Inside a prison, rapes are perpetrated by self-identified heterosexuals, men who identify as heterosexuals before and after, and they don't view what they're doing as gay sex. A lot of what goes on in prison goes on within this context of manhood and masculinity. Manhood is defined by what role you play in a sexual encounter. Those that are subjugated to a passive role are considered less than men. Gay men are viewed as fundamentally lacking in manhood. They view gay men as, because we like it, they're entitled to take it whenever they want. Once Tim Robbins' character was raped, he was now considered gay. He was turned out, is the expression they used, as if they had turned him gay. They took his manhood. It's an irrevocable process. Once it's taken, you never get it back. You need a man to protect you from that point forward. The forced feminization that goes on is to provide a even further psychological distance for them to of the notion of having gay sex. The violence that goes on has more to do with power than it is about sex. I mean, that's an important thing to think about. I mean, it's been 29 years since this happened to me, but you know, prisons are really small worlds. If I was back in Michigan and gone into the prisons, I guarantee you there'd be somebody there that would remember me, and I'd immediately go back to my place in the hierarchy. Rape is just, you know, one example of some of the violence that goes on. There was a study in Pennsylvania of gay men in particular in prison, and gay men were in that, according to that study, were four times as likely to be victimized than all other inmates. In my experience, I think that number is grossly underreported. I think a gay man has almost 100% chance of being victimized inside of a jail or a prison. You know, basically, what I've been doing is, you know, telling anybody I can. You know, anybody that'll listen, you know, I want to talk to them about prisoner rape and about what really goes on inside of our prisons and what it's really like. The gay community's been slow to come around to this issue, and, you know, I've been really making it my mission to try to get this out there because, you know, the sad reality is we've got a disproportionate representation of gay people in prisons for a lot of the reasons or some of the issues that a lot of us in this room have all struggled with. You know, we all had to come to terms with our identity, but there's many gay men that are kicked out of their homes because their families reject them. They're forced out of their schools because they're ridiculed or abused, so they don't have an education. They find themselves in sex work because they can't find jobs, and then they find themselves in the criminal justice system. And then once they're in the justice system, they're abused beyond belief, and the apathy is just, you know, unacceptable. Gay men are viewed as fundamentally lacking in manhood. That kind of attitude is pervasive among corrections officials as well, guards that work in these prisons. There was a highly publicized case last year in Texas of a gay man who, at the hands of prison gangs, was forced into prostitution every day for 18 months, and he was there for writing bad checks, by the way. So he wasn't like some hardened criminal. He was just, this guy, you know, made some pretty bad choices. Every day he was forced into prostitution, he filed 7 formal grievances begging for protection. And he was told one time, you're gay, you like it, don't you? Another time he was told, well, if you don't want to be raped, go back out there and be a man, because I'm not going to get in the middle of a lover's quarrel. Tell me. It wasn't until the ACLU filed a lawsuit on his behalf that they moved him into protective custody. I think that kind of apathy is just as criminal as the activity that landed some of us there in the first place. I'll be searching everywhere just to find someone who cares. I've been trying to understand, why is it there's been this slow coming of the gay community? We have a tendency to trivialize things or sexualize things. I did a search on the internet once of gay porn. I went to an engine that you could sort by actor, by fetish, by title. But I did a search on jail or prison sex fantasies. 114 titles, 114 different videos. And Power Tool, which is the number one selling gay porn of all time, is set in jail. Last year, the Prison Rape Elimination Commission held a hearing in San Francisco. This is a commission of 9 members, 5 of which were appointed by a Republican administration, very conservative. But they held this hearing in San Francisco to focus very specifically on issues affecting LGBT prisoners. That very same night, a few blocks away in a hotel, there was a Bears Behind Bars theme party that went on. I'm glad the religious right didn't find out about that, because they could have really gone to town with that one. Tell me. I would love to see more involvement on the part of the gay community.